Hey, good afternoon, everyone. Pastor Brett here, and yes, I am in Ollie's. Hallelujah, where good stuff is truly cheap. Hallelujah. So I'm going to turn you around here and show you what I found. Hallelujah. Steve, you wish you were here today, buddy. Look, I come over here and I look, and I noticed this was empty the last time I was here, this shelf. And I saw some stuff up here. So I walk up and I find this. Well, my wife has it in the cart over there, all right? But this is the New King James Version called Throwback Ground Study Bible. It's a New King James Version, so I took it for her, and she likes the NKJV text. And this is a clamshell box. It's a nice quarter-inch style. Yeah, Steve, imagine me looking at a quarter-inch style Bible cover. Feels like leather, but it's not. Corners are wrapped in a faux leather. This is more like a, I want to say polymer, but not an ironed polymer. It has a design to it. It's okay. It's perimeter stitched. It's nice. It's a paper paste down, but when you get inside, it's a quality study Bible, cultural background study Bible. And they show you what's going on. When you interpret the Bible, part of hermeneutics teaches you that the Bible is to be interpreted culturally whenever possible, of course. And so you want to understand the culture around the scriptures, where the scriptures came from. It's important. So this is a very, very nice Bible. They make it look old, too, by frosting the ends of the pages, giving that scroll-type look, ancient parchment or something. And you have acknowledgments and everything about the authors. Talk about Jesus. Hallelujah. Preface to the New King James, Hebrew-English translation chart. Now, that's something you might want to look at. Get my fingers out of the way. Pause that and look at that. That might be a good chart to have handy at your house. Yep. You know, let's pause that and look at that. Hebrew to English translation chart. Telling you everything you should need to know about translating from Hebrew to English. There. And I think one more page, no. And then you go into some archaeological finds they show you, and ancient texts relating to the Old Testament. It's important things to know, folks. Then you got chronology of the Bible. And then you get to the Old Testament. The Torah, narrative literature, wisdom and hymnic literature, oracles of the prophets. Major backgrounds, issues from ancient Near East. Now, this thing is loaded with articles, and I'm trying to show you page by page just until we get to the first book of Genesis, then we'll flip through and look at the rest. Here's the Torah. Then God establishes his covenant, Genesis. And this is your introduction. Of course, it's quite extensive. Not very extensive. Well, it wasn't. It was only one page. Here's the text. Center column reference. The opacity is bad. This paper is very thin. So you're going to get a lot of show through, a lot of ghosting here. And because it's a serif font, it's not as easy to read. But it's a great study Bible, it really is. If you can get past the opacity issue, then you have a lot of great information in here. And red letters, it's done well. It's not bright red, pink or anything, so it's readable because of the way that they the bronze looked it put to this and made it look like parchment paper. It's as thin as some parchment paper I've seen. Crucifixion. There's an article right there about the crucifixion. You can pause it and read it. There you go. Harmony of the Gospels, and then you get the Book of Acts. And that is a quick look at the New King James Version Cultural Background Study Bible. Okay. Hope that was a blessing because I found this. Steve, flip. Oh, no, not the vines again, right? We've seen that before, Pastor Brett. This is a great Bible, expository Bible. Has an opacity issue as well. Very, very thin paper. And the ghosting is horrible. It is the comfort print, and it is line upon line. It's line matched. So, having said that, it's an easy read because of the line matching. And it shows you an example of the text because it's comfort print. Here's the problem with it, though. When I looked at this and I saw this, I said, what the? And then look. Oh, it's Thomas Nelson leather. Yes, it is. It's that same Thomas Nelson leather that's on their signature series that's... my wife has a New King James. It's the same leather. It's a goatskin leather. There's an ISBN. And there's the problem. In the cutting process, this was folded in, so it didn't get cut right. And so when you unfold it, all the pages there, the text and everything is present. But I'll just draw the line, and then I'll cut it with scissors at home. I have paper cutting scissors at home. There's an issue with the opacity. A dark gray embossing paneling, and you see what it does. It shows through horribly. So that when you do get to the text, here's text block. Text block interrupted, see? Something behind. Because the opacity is bad. The word is line upon line. It's line matched, so. Okay. Let that show through two pages. Or one whole page. Yeah. Okay, I'm coming. So, this is a great Bible, otherwise. It's an exegete. He's an exegete. This is an exegetical study Bible. So, It's an expository Bible. Word studies throughout. Let's see. Word studies throughout. Nice, right? Okay, well, that's it. My wife has gotten lost on me, so I'm going to go find her, and we'll look at this and some other things a little later on, okay? And keep us in prayer because we certainly need it. Amen. Hey, God bless you, everybody. Thank you for watching. Have a great day in Jesus' name.